बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स. इंस्ट्रक्शंस बिफोर द टॉपिक, लेट मी क्लियर टू यू. मस्ट बी अटेंटिव ड्यूरिंग द क्लास. यू शुड हैव योर रिक्वायर्ड स्टेशनरी. आस्क क्वेश्चंस आफ्टर कंप्लीट एक्सप्लेनेशन. डू नॉट टर्न ऑन योर वीडियो ड्यूरिंग क्लास. डू द होम टास्क प्रॉपरली इन योर फेयर कॉपी. बाय मिस्टेक इट्स टेस्ट कॉपी इन योर फेयर कॉपी. ओके, टुडेज टॉपिक इज ग्रामर टॉपिक अगेन, दैट इज नरेशंस, एंड वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द टॉपिक नरेशन. Okay, before starting today's explanation, let me show you a summarized preview. Okay, direct speech. Direct speech reports or quotes the exact words spoken. We do not change the exact words of the speaker in the direct speech. Indirect speech is also known as reported speech. This speaker's words we change into indirect speech, and that words now called reported speech in an indirect speech. Okay, its purpose is to report exactly what was said by someone by using quotation marks. Actually, why we use direct narration? Because we want to narrate or quote the exact words without any changing, without any alteration. We just exactly say what someone has said. And in indirect narration, its purpose is to report on what someone said in the past. In the past means when someone has said something, so that has become past. So we do some changes and we narrate actual message, but with some changings. We do not change what someone has said, but we make some changes that do not change the actual message of the speaker's words. It is accompanied by a reporting verb, signal phrase or quotative frame. In a direct narration, reporting verb we add before reported speech, before the exact words. Signal phrase, we also use kind of phrases to refer what someone was in a mood while saying something. It's not necessary to use say. Sometimes we say yell, sometimes we say shout, the different kinds of utterance words. Or quotative frame, we use quotative frame means we use inverted commas to show it as exact words. So that is called quotative frame. It uses reporting verbs such as say, tell, said, talk, and speak. We just use these reporting verbs and then we connect them with the connective and write down the remaining part of the sentence, what the speaker has said with the changes of pronoun and some other changes. Okay, you will keep the verb tense the same in the quotations. When you write down quotative in the form of quotative frame, indirect speech, we do not change the tense. What someone has said at that time, it was present, it was future, it was past, whatever it was, we write down in the same, because we don't change any exact words means we do not make any kind of changes. In indirect speech, normally you will change the verb tense when using indirect speech. Especially, we change the verb tense when the reporting verb is in past tense. Otherwise, we don't change verb as well. But we do some other changes also. And verb is also changed. The change of verb, the change of tense, you can say, is an important part of indirect speech. It's when the reporting verb is in past. So this is a preview I'm just sharing with you. I think you have recalled yesterday's memory, what you learned yesterday. Let's proceed with some more details. Okay, narrations according to the type of sentence. How many type of sentences there are? There are five types of sentences. First one is called assertive and declarative also. You can call it assertive sentence or you can call it declarative sentence. Remember, assertive does not mean only positive assertive or positive declarative. assertive sentence means somehow you can say statement, and a statement can be positive as well as negative. As I say, she is a doctor is an assertive sentence. If I say she is not a doctor is also an assertive sentence, because these sentences give information. They assert something, they declare something. That's why they are called assertive and declarative. Second one is interrogative sentences. All kind of questions, we take them as interrogative sentence. There are direct questions as well as indirect questions, but all kind of questions are called interrogative sentences. Imperative sentences, when we talk about ordering to someone, when we have to suggest something to someone, when we have to advise someone, warn someone. So we use imperative sentences. They are a little different from other kind of sentences, as they do not have any past tense. They are used then and there, and they are always spoken to the second person. That's why they are not in past, they are not in future. They are only used in the form of negative and positive imperatives, and we say then and there, and the subject is understood. We talk to the second person, so the you is understood. That's why we do not add the subject in imperative sentence. We just start these sentences with verb. Exclamatory sentences. What are exclamatory sentences? Exclamatory sentences are the sentences where the speaker shares sudden emotions like feeling of happiness, feeling of sadness, feeling of excitement, any kind of. Exclamatory sentences sometimes may be incomplete, because we just make exclamatory sentences for showing or sharing or expressing feelings. So it's not necessary to make a full sentence while making exclamatory sentences. This might be an incomplete sentence as well, but somehow we understand, because with the context we can understand what the sentence is about. And exclamatory sentences are also closed by adding a sign of exclamation. Number 5. Optative sentence. Exclamatory and optative sentence, they seem alike somehow, but there is a minor difference. In exclamatory sentences, we talk about sudden emotions, sudden feelings. We put sign of exclamation to show that is about strong feelings and emotions that are commonly sudden. But and that exclamatory sentence can be incomplete, but optative sentences are complete sentences. We talk about wish, prayer, desires for making for making desires, vision, prayer, we make optative sentences. So there is a little difference between the fourth and fifth one, exclamatory sentences and optative sentences. Now sentence wise we will learn the indirect narration and their rules. Okay. Assertive sentences. Sentences that make a statement are called assertive sentences, as I have told you. These sentences may be positive, negative, false or true statements. We don't seek if the statement is false or true. If I am 30 years old and if I say I am 28 years old, it doesn't matter. The statement is false, but the grammatical structure is right. To convert such sentences into indirect narration, use the rules as mentioned above, except said is something replaced with told. Look at the following examples. She says, I am writing a letter to my brother. This is the direct speech. Okay. In these sentences, what we do, we use that. We use that and we change say or said with told, commonly tell or told. Okay. Direct speech. She says, I'm writing a letter to my brother. This is direct speech. Okay. Indirect speech. She says that she is. We are adding that to omit commas. That is, this is the connective we use in assertive sentences. Which connective we use? That we use. She, I is first person pronoun. We will change according to the subject of reporting speech. That is she. So we will put she here. She is writing a letter to her brother. My again first person possessive pronoun according to subject of reporting speech, that is she. So possessive of she is her. But what we did here, we changed pronouns, we added that and omitted inverted commas. Why didn't we change the tense? Because the reporting verb is in present tense. Next example. She says, I was not writing a letter to my brother. Same sentence in past tense, someone is saying. She says that, again we are putting that is a connective for assertive sentences. She was not writing a letter to her brother. Her and she, I have told you, these are pronouns. We change according to the rule that I and my, both are first person pronouns. They are changed according to the subject of reporting verb. Imperative sentences. Imperative sentences are sentences that give an order or a direct command. These sentences may be in the shape of advice, entreaty, request or order. Mostly it depends upon the forcefulness of the speaker. Thus, a full stop or sign of exclamation is used at the end of the sentence. For ending an imperative sentence, we use full stop as well as sometimes we use sign of exclamation just to show that we are very intensely saying something, ordering something or suggesting something, requesting something. These are the examples. Shut the door. Please shut the door. Now we have added please. It means we are requesting. Shut the door. It might be the first one. Shut the door and sign of exclamation. It means that someone is saying with anger, with forcefulness. The second one, we are adding please. Now the mood of the sentence is different. Someone is saying in a very mood of being, very down to earth, you can say. Repair the door by tomorrow. Now it is a kind of order, or you can say maybe a normal suggestion to do something. Okay. The reporting verb is changed according to reported speech into order in case the sentence gives a direct command. If the imperative is about a command or order, let's see example. The teacher said to me, shut the door. Now it is an order. Teacher ordered the student to shut the door. It means okay, we will change the teacher ordered. What we are doing, we are changing said with the word ordered to refer the nature of imperative. Me to shut the door. C2. So for imperative sentences, which connective we use? We use to. The connective is to. In assertive sentence, the connective is that. In imperative sentence, the connective is to. That is infinitive actually. After to is infinitive. We use first form of verb, you know very well, to shut the door. If there were pronoun, shut the door in the sentence, so we would also change the pronouns accordingly. But there were no pronouns, that's why we did not change any other kind of thing. Okay. The reporting verb is changed according to reported speech into a request. If the reporting if the imperative is a kind of request, he said to me, shut the door. In the above sentence, it is given that someone is saying that it's a request, although there is no other adverb is added that shows it's a request. So what will we do in place of order? As we changed said with order, we will change said with requested. He requested me to, this is the connective and called infinitive, to shut the door. The reporting verb is changed according to reported speech into advice, suggestion or advice if we are giving someone. So what we do? See the example. He said to me, you should work hard to pass the exam. In place of said, what will you do? You will change the said with advised or suggested. Okay. He advised me. You can say he suggested me that I should work hard to pass the exam. Okay. Here we are using that I should, but you can change it. He advised me to pass the exam. We can make it shorter as well, but he advised me that I should, because should we commonly do not change. okay, and this is not that kind of imperative. We start with verb. This imperative sentence is a suggestion, but this is not that kind of imperative. Actually, it's a kind of, it has a sense of imperative in it, but it is not that kind of imperative we make. We start with imperatives, we start with verb. So you should work. In place of you, you is a second pronoun, person pronoun. So we will change according to the object of reporting speech, that is me. And the nominative of me is I. So we are using I here. And should, we do not change. So I should work hard to pass the exams. Otherwise, in very informal talks, you can also say he advised me to pass the exam. Okay, because the word advice is showing something you should do. So you can make it shorter as well, especially while talking informally. The reporting verb is changed according to reported speech into forbade in case the sentence prevents someone from doing something. He said to me not to smoke. Okay, not to smoke again is or you can say don't smoke. Not to smoke is also correct. Don't get confused. We also say in such a way. Not to smoke. He said to me. He forbade. In place of said, what we are using? Forbade. Forbade means to stop someone from doing something. Forbade has the sense of no in it. That's why what we are going to do, he forbade me to. And then the verb. Why we skipped not? Because the word forbade has the sense of not in it. This is very important to remember. With forbade, we cannot add not. We cannot contain or we cannot continue not of reported speech, because this will be a wrong sentence. Forbade means stop someone to do something. If we do not change the word forbade and if we keep the word said intact, he said to me, then we will say he said to me to not to smoke. Okay. We said to him, mind your business. These are some examples I'm showing you. We urged him to mind his own business. We are changing the reporting verb in the indirect speech according to the nature of imperative. Mind your own business is a kind of serious warning or a serious suggestion, I should not say, serious kind of talk when you ask someone not to do something or do something particularly. She said to him, now the second one, consult a doctor. It's a suggestion. She suggested him to consult a doctor. We changed the word suggested with from said. Suggested, why? Because it seems a suggestion. The imperative seems a suggestion. He said to me, write it again. It seems an order, or order means a common command, as we say someone to do something without so much intensity. So we can use the word asked. He asked me to write it again. And if you are intensively, you know, saying something, then you may use order or commanded. You said to your father, please grant him leave for some time. Now it's a request. You requested your father to grant him leave for some time. Why we did not change him? Because it's a third person. It's a third person pronoun. So it will go intact in the reported, in the indirect speech. My mother said to me, never tell a lie. Okay, it's something mother is asking you not to do. My mother forbade me to tell a lie. We are using forbade. That's why we are not repeating not. We are or never. We are taking it out. The word for showing not or we are taking it out. That is never here. Okay. So my mother forbade. It means my mother stopped me to do something. So my mother forbade me to tell a lie. If I say my mother forbade me to not tell a lie, this will be a wrong sentence. Okay. My mother forbade me to tell a lie. Interrogative sentences. Those sentences which ask questions are called interrogative sentences. Any kind of question. Every interrogative sentence ends at a sign of interrogation. That is question mark. Do you live here? Question mark. We do not put a full stop. You know very well. Have you ever watched Terminator 3 movie? Is it raining? These are simple questions. I'm just showing you as an example. To convert interrogative sentence into direct indirect speech, follow the following rules along with the above mentioned rules. The reporting verb said to is changed into asked, because asked means ki we are inquiring something. Asked is not necessary. You can use question, you can use inquired. Asked is most common, actually. Commonly we use asked. Otherwise you can use some other kind of words that are synonyms of asked. If the reporting speech is having the reporting verb at its start, then if is used in place of that. Okay, if the question is if the reporting speech is having the reporting verb at its start. Okay, we use if the question is in the reported speech. So we use if, and if the question is, this is a little unclear, so listen to me carefully. If the question is confirmative, we use if to connect the reporting speech and reported speech. The reporting verb said to is changed into asked. If the reporting speech is having the reporting verb at it, it's a start, then if is used. Okay, I have told you. If the reporting speech is having interrogative words like who, when, how, why, when, then, neither, if it is used, nor any other word is added. For example, if the question is declarative with having different question words, that kind, that may be who, when, how, why, when, we use the same question word as a connective. We do not add if or whether. It's only if written here. We also can use whether. So we do not put if or whether. A full stop is placed at the end of the sentence instead of a mark of interrogation. These are called sentences. In indirect narration are called indirect sentences, and in indirect sentence we use full stop in place of question mark. So we change question mark with full stop. Okay, see the examples. I said to her, we will change into I asked her, when do you do your homework? I said to her, now the when question word, we will use the same question word as a connective here, when. Do you do your homework? This is a question. We will change into a statement because we have referred asked. That's why it is an indirect question. So we will use the structure of a statement from here. Okay. So we will cut do first of all. Now the subject, you. You is second person pronoun. We will change according to the object of reporting speech, that is her. And the nominative of her is she. So we will put she here. She did her homework. Again, your is second person possessive. So we will change according to the object, that is her homework. Got it? Now see. We said to him, are you ill? We asked him if he was ill. Here we are using asked in place of said. Okay. But the question, are you ill, is a confirmative question. Confirmative questions are those questions which have only two answers, yes or no. You just confirm, ki yes, I am, or no, I am not. We asked him if or whether. You can also put, he was ill. Are you ill? Present simple, we will change into past simple. In the first sentence, we also change the tense. It was in simple present and we change into simple past. So this is again simple present. Are you ill? We will change into simple past. And again, you is a second person pronoun. We will change according to the object, that is him, and its nominative is he. You said to me, have you read the article? You asked me if I had read the article. We are changing asked. We are putting if. Then we change the pronoun I, because you is second person and here it is me as an object, so we are putting I. Then we change the tense. This is present perfect. We will change into past perfect. Had read the article. The third form of read is read, you know very well. He said to her, the fourth one, he said to her, will you go to the Peshawar radio station? He asked her. We change asked, said to asked. If, because the question is confirmative, then we change the pronoun. You, second person pronoun, will be changed according to the object, that is her, and nominative of her is she. In will, we will change into would, that we do in future sentences. Go to the Peshawar radio stations. She says, who is he? she says who he is. The last sentence you can see, why did not we change the tense? Because the reporting verb is in present tense. Okay, one more thing we are doing, we are using says here. This is a printing mistake. We need to write asks. She asks who he is. Okay, please don't mind the printing mistakes. Exclamatory sentence, those sentences which express our feelings and emotions are called exclamatory sentences. Mark of exclamation is used at the end of an exclamatory sentence. For example, hooray, we have won the match. Alas, he failed in the test. How beautiful that dog is. There are two kind of use of exclamation mark, and I will teach you further inshallah. While taking to change exclamatory sentence into indirect speech, follow the following rules along with the above mentioned rules. In case there is an interjection, alas, aha, hooray, these are interjections, meaningless words in the reported speech, then they are omitted along with sign of exclamation. We don't follow them in indirect speech, but what we do, we put sign of exclamation at the end of the sentence. Reporting verb said is always replaced with exclaimed with joy. And if we write down exclaimed as well as we add adverb or adverbial phrase with joy or joyously, we also could say exclaimed with sorrow, exclaimed joyfully. Now this is directly adverb, exclaimed sorrowfully, or exclaimed with great wonder. With great wonder is again adverbial phrase. In case there is what or how at the beginning of the reported speech, then they are replaced with very or very great. How and what, these are actually we use as interjections in exclamatory sentences. Actually not interjections, in exclamatory sentence we use them to show intensity, so we change them with very and very great. In an indirect sentence, the exclamatory sentence becomes an assertive sentence because we refer the exclamation in the reporting speech by changing the reporting verb. Then we carry the assertive sentence after linking the reporting speech with reported speech. See the examples. He said, hooray, I have won the match. He exclaimed with great joy. Hooray shows that someone is very happy. That we use with connective in exclamatory sentences. We use that he had won the match. Have won the match, present perfect. We are changing into past perfect and we are just putting full stop here. Okay. You could also add sign of exclamation here if you want. Okay. She said, alas, my brother failed in the test. She exclaimed with great sorrow. Alas means someone is unhappy that her brother had failed in the test. So these are different examples. You can see, I'm going towards the next one. Optative sentences. Those sentences which express hope, prayer, or wish are called optative sentences. Usually there is a mark of exclamation at the end of optative sentence. We also use sign of exclamation at the end of the optative sentences. Commonly they are start with may and may and hope. May you succeed in the test. May you get well soon. These are the examples. Would that I were rich. Would that means, I wish like. To change optative sentence into indirect speech, follow the following rules along with the above mentioned rules. In case the reported speech starts with the word may, then the reporting verb said is replaced with the word prayed. May shows that someone is praying or wishing something for you, for someone or for you. In case the reported speech starts with the word would, then the reporting verb said is replaced with the word wished. May is changed in might. Mark of exclamation is omitted. In indirect speech, the optative sentences become assertive sentences, quite similar like the exclamatory sentences. Mark of exclamation we omit. Okay, sorry, I said in exclamatory sentence you could add exclamatory sentence at the end of reported indirect speech. No, sorry, you could not. This by mistake I said so. You could not add exclamatory sign of exclamation there. Okay. These are the examples. Examples will clear you better. He said to me, may you live long. He prayed. We are changing may with prayed. So we will not carry on may again. He prayed that I might live long. You can understand that it's a second person pronoun. We will change according to the object of reporting a speech. That is me. So we are putting I. May will be changed into might. So I might live long. Got it? Because we are adding the word prayed in reporting a speech, we are not going to keep the word may intact. Next, my mother said to me, may you succeed in the test. My mother prayed, because again it's may, prayed that I might succeed in the test. We are changing may into might and pronouns accordingly. You is second person. We will change according to me, and nominative of me is I. Number three, she said, would that I were rich. She wished. Would that means ke someone is wishing for you or someone is hoping that something. She wished she had been rich. Okay. One thing is missing here. She wished that. Here that. When we write in a literary writing or formal writing, so we add that here. Actually, this sentence is not wrong. Okay. But in formal writing, we add that. We follow rules strictly. But in informal speaking or casual speaking, we also can skip the connective because it is also clear. So this is not grammatically wrong. You may add that here if you are writing with every rule, especially for writing in school work and college work. They expect you to add that. Otherwise, this is not wrong. Don't get confused. Okay. I said to him, would that you were here on Sunday. I wished, again, that is missing, but that is right. In the report, indirect speech, the word that is missing, but don't get confused. We also can do in the same way. I wished he had been there on Sunday. Okay, you may add that for making it more perfect, but without that, the sentence is also correct, especially while talking to someone informally. Okay. Let's move on. Home assignment I'm going to share with you. Okay, I hope you have got what I made you understand. Change the following sentence into indirect speech. She said to me, I like you. These are different sentences. I like you very much. I said to her, these are mixed actually. Questions are there, imperatives are there and all. Okay, these are some more. Take a screenshot side by side. Okay. Take a screenshot quickly. You are supposed to take a screenshot quickly. I'm giving you time. Please, girls, take a screenshot because this is your homework. You have to do in your copy. Okay. Change the following sentences into direct speech. Now you are reversing the sentences. We learned direct speech and how to change into indirect, but when we learn it, so we can successfully reverse the process. We can change the indirect speech into direct speech if we have clear understanding. These are only six sentences. Quickly take screenshot and you will change these sentences into indirect speech. Girls, in your exams, you are given grammar in the form of MCQs, but I am giving you as do as directed. You have to change directly because of your better practice. If you do this successfully, so to select a correct answer in MCQs will be an easy task for you. Okay, let's end with this quotation. Perfection belongs to narrated events, not to those we live. People tell us different kinds of stories, their experiences, they narrate us. So that actually bring perfection if we take them seriously and if we take messages from them. It's not only something that we are living in. We learn from the experiences and observations of others. Okay, so I think it's a nice quotation. Okay, so I'm going to finish today's class and I hope you have got what I made you understand and you will do the work properly in your fair copies. Okay, take care. Allah Hafiz.